I teach business education, which is introduction to business, accounting, and marketing.
I am teaching the new pre-engineering courses, which include design and modeling, robotics, and then engineering one.
I teach Spanish 1, 2, and 3.
So this is my second year of full-time teaching.
This is my 8 years teaching. I have been a teacher for 13 years.
What's what I like best about teaching? Just being able to hopefully have a positive impact on students' lives.
I like that the kids, for the most part, are very nice. I've been at some other schools where it's not always the case, so most of you are responsible and fun to watch sometimes.
I just really like getting to know the students. I like teaching them about Spanish, obviously, the culture, all that stuff.
It's always what I wanted to do, and I was kind of out in the business world for a long time, and the part that I always enjoyed the most was when I got to get up and do training or teaching or something like that. Just being able to see students and interact with them every day and kind of see what's going on in their lives and to have a positive impact and kind of see maybe a light bulb go off where they maybe have struggled with something before and now they're starting to get it.
So I originally applied to Florida to help get my certificate because I didn't go to education for schooling. And I originally just applied because I enjoyed science, and then it's kind of progressed from that to as weird as it sounds, I enjoy being in the school system. I like watching the kids grow. I'm excited to be in a 7 through 12. I've always had one grade level and they've had to kind of go off and I don't really get to see them again. So I'm excited to see kids go from here to graduation.
I didn't always know that I wanted to be a teacher. I kind of came to it the long way. I had have a business degree and I worked at a company and I just didn't like it. And I wanted to do something more with my Spanish degree, so I got into teaching. I like getting to know the students, teaching them about the Spanish language and culture.
I want to say probably just the very first day of being able to, I was here quite a bit over the summer getting everything set up and of course going through training, and then we had a few different days with just teachers here. And so when the students finally arrived and I finally got to interact with and have classes and things like that, that's my favorite memory so far.
I mean, like I said, you guys are fun to watch. So we've got seventh graders who have the desire to show the worm consistently. Some of your class that likes to have dancing seizures with headphones. It's always a good time.
I think it would probably be teaching Spanish 1. It's probably been 8 years since I taught it, and I was like, oh, I don't know about that, but it's actually been really great.
A few different things. I cook. I write and play music and record, so I've got a SoundCloud account with my music out there and things like that, so that's what I enjoy doing.
I have a lot of other jobs, so I farm. I do that a lot, and then I'm a referee for sports all season, so I pretty much am out of school or out in my field.
I like to read and run. I feel like that's very basic, but.
Try your best every single day that you're here, and don't get too upset if something doesn't go right. You've got a really, really, really long life ahead of you, and you're gonna make mistakes and learn from it, but things will probably work out very, very well for you in the end if you just kind of stay calm and stay focused.
Despite how you guys might feel at times, we're here to help you. Sometimes us pushing you isn't us picking on you. It's that we see potential and we don't want you to waste it.
Oh gosh, that's a really tough one. Stay organized, get folders for all of your classes. Don't just shove all your papers into one giant binder. I think all of your teachers would appreciate that.
Season went pretty good. It was always enjoyable. And the girls did win a match this year in our conference match. I know they would have liked to won some more, but if we could have cut some strokes off, we'd have been right there and we'd have won some because we had some tight matches.
Bill Wise.
Season went very well. I don't know her exact record, but we did finish third in the league.
Our record this year was 3-7. I thought we had a great year, though. If you look at the growth we've had amongst the years, been amazing. There's some stats out there that have us at the number four most improved team in Division VI football this year.
Went great as far as both perspectives of our girls and boys. Our goal every year is just to make sure we make lots of growth. and continue to get better as we go. And I think both teams did that as a full team. So you want to be running your best at the end of the year, and that's basically what most of the kids did. So great year, fun, worked hard, and came together as a team.
Our record was 18-6. We won the TRC. We were league champions, first time in a very long time. I don't even know if some of you guys were even born yet the last time we won the TRC. So we had a really good season.
Toughest opponent? Well, the ones that beat us by the most strokes would have been Fort Laramie, I believe it was. Plus, that was the first time we'd ever played Arrowhead, and it's a tough course anyway. So being the first time, I think that was the course we shot our highest team score on. So
Bethel and Layman both were a little bit better than us this year.
Not really a specific matchup. I think it's just ourselves. I get it's just is what you're always going against is to be the best version of yourself every day. So that's always the toughest opponent.
Well, cross is kind of different because it's a similar track. You know a lot about that. When we go to meets, you're not running against per se just folks in our league. So when we go places, we're running against Tip, Centerville, Troy. But as far as our league or our league goes, Milton ended up pretty much taking league title during the league meet and did a nice job, both teams, boys and girls. But like as far as weekly, when we're running, it just everyone's so good. You're seeing lots of people from different divisions. So, but lots of good small schools around here, but lots of good big schools. So,
well, Bella Badorf was our medalist this year. She had the lowest score, lowest average for the team. And then Callie Edgel was next. And then Allison Burns, and then Emma Ouellette.
Obviously, Matt Dieprink is a star player. Brody Manson's right there. Jaden Wackler, newcomer this year, was pretty solid.
I think our O-line, and O-line and D-line have been amazing this year. Really stepping up and kind of leading. Leading the team, and we've a lot of the success is starts with those guys. They you know, everything they do, set up the run game, the pass game, set the defense up a lot. So our offensive defensive line being really big this year.
I would say I'm looking right now. Obviously, in this way we want it to be. Our seniors, pretty much are our best, and that is because they work their tails off. When I look at, we had quite a few seniors on our boys team. And you got Chris Beaton, Beck Wilson. Beck was our only boy to make All-League. Chris was second All-League. Caleb Henry, Preston Keene, Noah Chaney. All those older upperclassmen are good. And then we had one senior on the girls' side, not with Eliza. She obviously was our best, so had a great season. Still going, actually. She's got one more week.
Yeah.
I thought she was Grand State. So she just ran state, but she has been invited to represent Ohio, so she gets to run against some other states. So that's an invite. So it's pretty cool.
Yeah, that's cool. Who would you say your most improved players were?
Definitely Emma and Allison were the most improved players. They cut their strokes off by about 8 to 10 strokes.
Most improved player? Braren Denson has improved a lot throughout the season, and Caleb Smith made some good progress too.
First one on top of my head is Mo, Lucas Lester. He is... really, it's been a huge improvement this year from last year. So that's been a big one. The other two, I mean, there's a lot. I mean, Jordan Miller had a huge year, coming as a sophomore. And then probably Landon Castle, stepping up a quarterback and kind of owning the offense.
You know, lots of them improved a ton. Bella Welch on the girls' side did a nice job improving her time and really just the way she pushed herself. So sometimes, not even time-wise, it's just the overall the makeup of how they raced and the way they started gutting stuff out. And I would say on the boys' side, could be a number of kids. Noah really cut some time off, but probably overall consistently our most improved would probably be Kid Wellborn, along with Chris. Our seniors all improved too, but Kent really did a nice job of improving through the season.
Our most improved player this year was Ava Hartwig.
This is my third year for girls golf. And I think just, you know, seeing the girls improve, you know, week after week, is, you know, probably one of the more enjoyable things. Them listening to what you tell them to do to tweak their swing and so on and so forth, and everything coming through and working for them.
I believe this is my 20th season coaching boys golf. You know, I love being around the kids. The kids are great, usually. Working with them and watching them progress is a lot of fun.
Overall, this is year 10 coaching football. It's my fourth year here at Covington. The best part is just the experiences and the relationships you build with players along the way, even when they annoy you sometimes.
I don't know what he's looking at.
No, but the time spent, all the hours put in with players, and that you get to have some good stories at the end of it is the best part.
So this is my 19th season as a cross country coach. Yeah, so it's been a long time. I just feel like we just got awesome kids, and it is an individualized team sport. So when our team is good, it makes it more fun. Mm-hmm. But you do have a chance as an individual to succeed and do things if the rest of our team isn't coming along. But the thing is, it's such a great community to be around. The kids get lots of friends each week because you're running. You want to be kids, but they're all friends afterwards. I mean, so similar again to a lot of other sports, but there's a lot of social interactions between the kids and coaches. So all the coaches support our kids, we support theirs, and kind of the kids support each other. Not that they don't want to be our, but it's a good atmosphere.
I'm Sam Hellman. I'm here with
Ms. Elrek.
And this is Finish the Lyrics. I'm here with
Danny.
And this is Finish the Lyrics Part 2.
I'm not with you. I'm paralyzed.
Huh? That is, in fact, not correct.
More than you could ever know.
Keep going.
Oh.
Make my wish come true. All I want for Christmas is you.
And we have a winner that round. It was Rowan.
I'm here with
Sam Hellman. So I put my hands up to play my song, the butterflies fly away. Nodding my head like yeah, moving my hips like yeah. I'm done. I'm here with
Ken Wellworth.
And this is his pregame interview. How do you feel going into this match?
I think it's going to be pretty easy. I mean, I don't think he can shoot, so should be pretty easy.
Is that it?
Yes, sir.
I bet. They're currently shooting for who actually gets a shot first.
Yeah.
Both switched it, so running again, going it, so someone misses.
13.
Yeah. Ken actually swishes it.
14.
And he bricks it. So Kent gets first shot. Alright, here goes Kent with the shot. He swishes it. Here goes Sean. Oh, he bricks it! Sean with the P. Kent with the shot. Oh, and he bricks it. Here goes Sean Naff. Quick little layup in there. Here goes Kent with the shot. And he makes it.
Yeah.
And then right from there, oh! Here goes
Discount with a shot?
Range.
I don't think he did.
Ladies and gentlemen, nope.
Oh, and he bricks it off the box. Yep. See what Sean Knapp's gonna do for his shot. He's a legend, so they say. Oh, from behind the backboard. Oh, Kent with the corner three. Shots up.
Oh, I missed.
Here goes Sean Knapp. Oh, he swishes it. Here goes Kent with the free throw. Oh, Sean Knapp still with the P.
Nope.
Oh, and misses it. From the U. Let's go, Kent. Takes the shot. Oh, and misses it. Here goes Sean Knapp. Gonna go for another behind the backboard. Takes the shot.
Wow.
And he makes it. Here goes Kent. This is for P.
You're not that guy, pal. Trust me. You're not that guy.
They are both PP. Funny word. Here goes Sean Knapp with the free throw. Oh, swishes it. Here goes Kent with the free throw. Oh. But absolutely bricks it with the left hand. Left hand three-pointer. Oh, and bricks it. Okay. We have Kent here with the half court. Oh, and he makes it. Here goes Sean Knapp with the rebuttal. Getting ready. He's gonna shoot it like a free throw. And boom. Does not make it. They both have a PI on. Here goes Kent with the behind the back three. Shots up. Ooh, hits the rim. And we got Sean Knapp with the rebuttal here. He shoots it up and he makes it from the elbow. This is four game. He's undefeated, he says. Sean Knapp. All right, how do you two feel about the game you just played?
I gotta work on my fundamental shots now that I just lost off of one of them.
His left-handed free throw was pretty bad. Okay, he got to score with both hands, but I knew I was going to win. When he asked me, I knew I was going to win.
Mr. Knapp, how do you feel about the win?
I mean, I'm humble. Gracious and the best ever. Okay? That's what I feel.
How do you feel the loss?
I mean, it's whatever. He's got to be humble, so humblest man I know.
Anything else to add?
Goat.
Go Buck.
Go Buccs.